Hello dear students, welcome to mathematics class. In this class, let us discuss the third case of finding the particular integral. So already we have completed two cases of the particular integral. In the first case, the RHS is of the form e power ax, and in the second case, sin ax or cos ax. And we have also discussed the case of failure for the first and second case, means if the denominator is zero, then how to find its particular integral. So now let us move towards the third case of finding the particular integral. So here the RHS is of the form x power m, where m is any positive integer. So here this is the method or rule to find the particular integral when RHS is x power m, where m is a positive integer. So that is 1 divided by f of d x power m. So here f of d becomes, means that symbolic form of the differential equation, the d squared minus d cube plus d square plus some constant, that is equal to x power m, where m is positive integer. So here that m must be, the power of x should be positive, then only we can apply this particular integral. So here we have some steps to solve this type of the particular integral. So here the first step, take out the lowest degree term from f of d to make the first term unity, and the remaining factor will be of the form 1 plus phi of d or 1 minus phi of d. So here this is the first step. So means if any equation is given in terms of d, so from that we need to take out some term. That term should be the lowest degree term. Suppose in the equation there are three terms, for example d cube, d square and d. So here among these three, what is the lowest degree term? D is the lowest degree term. Then we need to take that d outside, then that becomes 1 plus or minus some function of d is remaining. And if constant is there, for example d square plus d plus 2, then the 2 is the lowest degree term, because that power of d is equal to 0 along with 2. So therefore we need to take that 2 outside, then that becomes 1, and remaining function of d will be as it is. And the next thing, now here f of d is in denominator, so therefore these two terms, either this or this, will be in the denominator. Then in the next step we need to take them to the numerator. So that is, that becomes 1 plus phi of d whole power minus 1 or 1 minus phi of d whole power minus 1. So therefore here these two are the terms which are in the numerator. Now next and the last step is we need to expand these two accordingly. So expand them by following expansions. So here 1 minus x whole power minus 1 means it is of the second term, 1 minus x whole power minus 1. That becomes 1 plus x square plus x cube and so on up to infinity. And then the next one, 1 plus x whole power minus 1, that is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube and so on. Or 1 minus x whole power minus 2. Then it is 1 plus 2x plus 3x square minus 4x cube and so on. And 1 plus x whole power minus 2, that is 1 minus 2x plus 3x square minus 4x cube, alternatively minus and plus. So if the sign in the bracket is plus, then we will get the alternative plus sign minus in the expansion. If it is negative, then complete positive terms will be in the expansion. And 1 minus x minus 3, 1 plus x minus 3. So these are the expansions. In general, there are two expansions. One is 1 minus x whole power minus 1, that is 1 plus nx plus 1 divided by 2 n into n plus 1 x square plus 1 by 6 n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 x cube and so on. And 1 plus x whole power minus n, then that becomes 1 minus x plus 1 by 2 n into n plus 1 x square minus 1 by 6 n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 x cube and so on. So here 1 plus phi of d. So here phi of d is a function of d into x power m will be there. So here depending on the power of x, we need to take the terms in the expansion. So here these expansions is to be carried out or carried up to d power m, since d power m plus 1 of x power m equal to 0 and d power m plus 2 of x power m equal to 0 and all the higher differential coefficients of x power m vanish. So here it means that if x square is there, then what is the third order derivative of x square? That is equal to 0, because the first order derivative of x square is 2x and second order derivative of 2x is, or x square is 2, then if you differentiate third time, that will become 0. Means if the power of x is 2, then its third order derivative is 0, and if the power of x is 5, then its sixth order derivative is equal to 0. Means depending on the power of x, we need to find the expansions, or we need to consider the terms of the expansion. So here be careful while taking the expansion. If the power of x is 2, then consider only the terms in which the power of d is 2. If the power of d becomes 3, what is d? The d by dx. So therefore, if the power of d becomes 3 and its value is equal to 0. So that is the meaning of these two lines. So these expansions, so here these expansions are to be carried up to d power m. Whenever x power m is there, then we can consider up to mth derivative, and its m plus 1th derivative, m plus 2 derivative and m plus 3, m plus 4 and so on, all the higher order derivatives of x power m will be equal to 0. So therefore, no need to consider the higher order derivatives regarding the value of m. And let us discuss some examples. So by looking at the examples, it will be this method or this theoretical part will be easier. So let us consider the first example. Solve the equation d square plus d minus 6 into y is equal to x. And now onwards, I will write that complementary function directly, because already we have solved so many examples on complementary function. So how to find the roots and how to write the complementary function. So therefore, I am not explaining that complementary function. And now onwards, I will write directly that complementary function and will go for the particular integral. So here the complementary function is c1 e power minus 3x plus c2 e power 2x, means the roots are minus 3 and 2, right? And now the particular integral, this is very important. So here, while finding the particular integral, so let us consider the steps one by one. So the first step is take out the lowest degree term from f of d to make the first term unity. So means here, what is the lowest degree term? So here power of d is 2 and here power of d is 1 and here power of d is 0, means 6 into d power 0 will be there, because d power 0 is 1. So therefore here d square d and d power 0, what is the lowest degree term? 6 is the lowest degree term. So therefore we need to take that 6 outside along with the sign which is associated with that lowest degree term. So if it is negative, take that negative sign along with that term. If it is positive, then no problem. So here it is minus 6 is there, then we should put that minus 6 outside. then that becomes 1 divided by, if you take that minus x common, then what is the remaining term? This is d square divided by minus x, because I have taken that minus x outside, plus d divided by minus x, and in place of minus x that will be plus 1, because I have taken that minus x outside from this function. Then that becomes d square by minus x, d by minus x plus 1 into x. Then write this in the standard form, that is 1 divided by minus x into 1 plus 1 plus or minus. So here we can write this, these two are negative, so therefore we can take that negative outside. Then remaining is what? D square by 6 plus d by 6 into x. So here 1 plus phi of d, the remaining factor will be of the form 1 plus phi of d or 1 minus phi of d. So therefore here 1 minus phi of d, the function of d, and in the next step we need to take that factor to the numerator, then it is equal to minus 1 by 6, this as it is. Then remaining 1 minus d square by 6 plus d by 6 whole power minus 1 into x. So now here what you have done, we have taken that minus 6 outside from the denominator, and then we have made the factor as 1 minus phi of d, and in the next step we have taken that in the numerator. Now it is of the form 1 minus x whole power minus 1. Then we need to expand this, minus 1 by 6. So here the power of x is what? 1. So means the derivative of x is 1, and second order derivative of x is what? 0. So therefore we can consider only the first order derivative of x, then all the higher order derivatives will become 0. So therefore here now expansion of 1 minus x whole power minus 1 is what? 1 plus x square minus x cube and so on. So therefore here 1 plus x is nothing but this whole term, that is d square by 6 plus d by 6 plus next term will be x square. X square means d square by 6 plus d by 6 whole square and cube into x. So here d square means that is the second order derivative. So what is the second order derivative of x? 0. Means here only the derivative becomes 0. So and for the next term it is of the form a plus b whole square. So after expansion of this one, the power of d will be greater than 1 only, because a square plus b square plus 2ab. A square means the power of d becomes 4, b square means d square, 2ab in that d square into d, that will be d cube, means there is no d term in the third or after the expansion of this one. So therefore no need to consider the higher order derivatives. So then here simply we can write this as 1 plus, we can exclude this d square because its value is 0, and remaining is d by 6 of x, because its value is 0. So that's why we are excluding that d square from the expansion. So if d square is 0, then d cube, d power 4, d power 5 all will be equal to 0. So therefore we are excluding all higher order derivatives, only consider the terms for which we can get the non-zero derivative. So for d we can get the non-zero derivative, then it is minus 1 divided by 6. Now multiply this x to these two terms, x plus here 1 by 6 into d of x, So already we know that what is d. So d is d by dx. So therefore minus 1 by 6 x plus 1 by 6, and the derivative of x is 1. So therefore this is the particular integral of the given equation. So here given equation is d square plus d minus 6 into y is equal to x. So here RHS is of the form x power m, where m is the positive integer and here m is equal to 1, which is positive, and the complementary function we have written directly. Now the particular integral. So while finding the particular integral, we need to take the lowest degree term outside along with the sign associated with that. So if negative sign is there, take that negative sign also outside from the function, then that becomes minus 6 outside here, then that minus 6 in place of that term will get 1, that is plus 1, because we have taken minus 6 outside. Then remaining d square by minus 6 and d by minus 6, from these two terms we have taken negative sign outside, then 1 minus d square by 6 plus d by 6 is remaining, and taking this to the numerator, that is of the form 1 minus fi of d whole power minus 1 into x. Then after expansion, we need to consider the terms for which the function will give the non-zero derivative. So here d square of x is 0, so therefore we are not considering d square. If d square itself is 0, then d cube, d power 4, d power 5, all the higher order derivatives will be equal to 0. So therefore consider only 1 plus d by 6 of x, then multiply this x to all the terms which are there inside the bracket, then simplify, you will get the required particular integral. So it is very simple. The next example, d square minus 4 into y is equal to x square. So here the complementary function is c1 e power 2x plus c2 e power minus 2x. So by looking at the complementary function, we can find the roots. Here the roots are 2 and minus 2. And next, particular integral. So here, whatever the equation given in the question has to be written in the denominator, that is already done. So 1 divided by d square minus 4 into x square. And then go on applying the steps one by one. So in the first step, we need to find the lowest degree term. So what is the lowest degree term here? D square is there and d power 0 along with minus 4. So it means that minus 4 is the lowest degree term. Then after finding the lowest degree term, we need to take that outside the function. Then the remaining function will be of the form 1 plus or minus phi of d. So here let us take that minus 4 outside. So 1 divided by minus 4 outside, and this d square becomes d square divided by minus 4, and minus 4 becomes plus 1 into x square, and write that in the standard form. So let us consider this minus 1 by 4 as it is. Then 1 divided by 1 minus d square by 4, just rearranging the terms. We have changed nothing, that 1 is written first and minus d square by 4 written second. And next thing is, we need to write this in the numerator. So therefore 1 minus d square by 4 whole power minus 1 x square. Now here RHS is x square. So here the value of m is equal to what? 2. So here value of m means power of x and power of d. We need to compare them. So if power of d is 2, okay, it will be non-zero. If power of d becomes 3, then that will give the value is equal to 0. Means power of d will give us the number of or order of the derivative. If the power of d is 2, then it is second order derivative. If the power of d is 3, then it is the third order derivative. So therefore, just compare them, and in the expansion, just consider the terms which have the power is equal to the value of m. Now here it is equal to minus 1 by 4 as it is. Then expansion of 1 minus x whole power minus 1, that is 1 plus x means d square by 4 plus x square. X square means d power 4 by 16. So here the value of d is there, that d power 0 is there, no problem. And in the second term, d power 2 is there, and that 2 is equal to what? M. So therefore we can consider this one. And the third term, here the value of or the power of d is 4, which is greater than m. If the power of d goes greater than m, then we need to stop the expansion because its value is equal to 0. Then it is minus 1 divided by 4, 1 plus d square divided by 4. And we can exclude the terms which have the power greater than m. So therefore it is 1 plus the d square by 4 of x square. Then it is minus 1 divided by 4. Now multiply the terms. 1 into x square, that is x square, plus 1 by 4 into d square of x square. D square of x square means second order derivative of x square. So what is the second order derivative of x square? So here we know that x square plus 1 divided by 4. So if you differentiate, so d by dx of x square is what? 2x. Then d square by dx square of x square means the differential of this one is 2. So therefore d square of x square is 2. Then it is minus 1 divided by 4 x square plus 1 divided by 2 is the required particular integral of the given differential equation. So if you complete the second step, then your 50% or more than 50% problem will be complete, because this is only important by means which is or where we need to take which term outside the function. So if you identify that term, then it is easy to proceed next. Then the next thing is we need to take that to the numerator, that 1 minus a function of d into whole power minus 1, then expansions. So here the power of that factor will be either minus 1 or minus 2, not greater than that. So therefore, just remember those two expansions, 1 plus x whole power minus 1, 1 minus x whole power minus 1, and 1 minus x whole power minus 2, and 1 plus x whole power minus 2.